Hey, what's going on guys? Josh from Fusion here and welcome back to another video. In today's video, I'm going to be showing you guys how to record with OBS Studio. OBS Studio is definitely the most popular way to record your desktop. On Windows, Mac, or Linux, any computer operating system you're on, OBS Studio works for. And in today's video, I'm going to be showing you guys how to download and install OBS Studio, how to set it up with the best settings for recording quality, and make sure you guys know everything that you need to know. Before we hop into the video, I would appreciate if you guys could go stream my new song, Money Up. It came out on September 28th, and it sounds a little something like this. I get the money, I get the bills, and I get the funds. What you gonna do, what we gonna do, we do it for fun. Pop out the tens, pop out the twenties, and pop out with ones. Get your money up, 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 up. Get your money up, 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 up. Get your money up, 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 up. If you guys like what you heard, you guys can click the link in the description or the first comment. Money Up is out on all platforms: Apple Music, SoundCloud, Spotify, anything you can think of. Okay guys, hopping over to Google, all you guys want to look up is OBS Studio or go to obsproject.com. I will have the link in the description. Once you guys head here, as you can see, OBS Studio, download for Windows, Mac OS, or Linux. They have a little picture down here of what OBS Studio looks like when you have it all set up with all the scenes and everything in it. This is how ours is going to look like at the end of this video. So for this video, I am going to download the Windows version of OBS Studio because I am on a Windows PC. So you just want to click on your corresponding version, select a download location and save it. And now we're going to run the installer that we just downloaded from OBS. There's a little pop-up saying, do you want to allow this app to make changes? You just want to click yes. And now we're in the OBS Studio setup wizard. These are all pretty much the same guys, and since I'm actually recording this tutorial using OBS Studio because I love OBS Studio and that's what I use for all my videos, I actually cannot show you guys how to install it from this point on. As you can see, it says OBS Studio is already running, but don't worry, like I said, the installer is really easy. Alright, now that OBS Studio is successfully installed on your device, you just want to launch up the application. Alright guys, now we're finally in OBS Studio and we can start setting up the program for the first time. So when you're first in here, I know it can look confusing at first. There's stuff all on the bottom and there's all these tabs on the top. But trust me, you'll get really familiar with this program pretty fast. It's actually really easy to use. The first thing we're going to be doing is we're going to be heading into the settings and making sure that all of our recording settings and everything are on the correct settings. Because when you first launch up the application, it does not have good settings. It has really bad settings on. If you were to record with these settings, your stuff would end up looking like potato Xbox 360 graphics. So you just want to head to the bottom right and go to settings. Now, if you want to change the theme for like how the whole program looks, you can do that up here. It says theme. You know, you can go onto the light theme. If you're a weirdo that likes light themes, personally, I love dark themes, so I'm gonna keep it on Yami. I think this looks perfect. And that's literally it for the general tab. Nothing else in here you guys have to mess with. And now that we're done with the general tab, we're gonna hit apply at the bottom and we're gonna move on. The next thing I want you guys to go into is the advanced settings all the way on the bottom. And the reason why we're jumping all the way down here is just because there's only a few settings we have to change in here. So I figured we'll just knock out the things with the least amount of settings at first. All right guys, now that we're in the advanced settings of OBS Studio, the first setting we have up here on the top is the process priority under the general tab. You guys are going to want to change this from normal to above normal. I noticed that OBS Studio kind of takes a lot of CPU power, so sometimes if you leave it on normal, it can actually struggle a little bit and your footage can lag. So I think it's best to leave it on above normal. Next, we're hopping down to this video tab and you guys can see the color space option right here. Default, it's gonna be on sRGB. This is gonna be lower quality. You guys are gonna wanna change this to Rec 709. This is actually gonna give you more colors. It's gonna make your video come out higher quality. And then right next to this option, the color range, you're gonna wanna click this and you're gonna wanna change it from limited to full. Again, gonna give more colors in your video, gonna make it more HD. And now we're done with the advanced tab and you can hit apply at the bottom and we're gonna move on. Next, we're gonna be hopping into the video tab. Like I said, guys, we're doing everything in backwards order. We're doing everything from the least settings to the most settings at the end. So now that we're in the video tab, guys, basically it's gonna have your base resolution up at the top. If you play normally on 1080, it's gonna be 1080. If it's 4K, you're gonna have your 4K resolution up there. And then they're gonna have the scaled down resolution below it. This is for if your PC isn't too good and you're playing at 1080p, but you only wanna record at 720 because it saves system resources. You can do that right here, but for me, I don't need to do that. I'm gonna hit the arrow and I'm gonna move it up to 1920 by 1080 so that I make sure that I'm recording in 1080p. And then next on top of that, we're gonna head down to the FPS values here where it says 30, and you wanna click on that and change it down to 60. Most videos nowadays are 1080 60, that's what looks good. So now we're gonna hit apply down at the bottom since we're done with the video tab. By the way guys, if you're looking for a server to join on Discord for content creators, you can post your videos here in the self-promotion channel, find people to play with to make videos, or if you even just wanna keep up with the latest on my channel and what's going on, make sure you guys join my Discord server, FUZIONHERE Cord. I'll have the link in the description. We have a ton of things to do in here, and I think you guys will really love it. Come check out FUZIONHERE Cord. And now we're gonna move into the audio tab. In audio, there's only like two options we need to change, and that's gonna be our desktop audio device and our mic. So most times, if you guys just put these on default, it will work because you probably already have your headphones as your default device and your microphone as your default device. But if not, OBS has options to select all your audio devices in here, so you can go in and find your device and select it. And once you get your desktop audio in here and your mic, you guys just want to click apply down at the bottom. Alright guys, now for the last and the biggest tab in OBS Studio, the output tab. In here, this is where all of our like recording settings are. Up at the top, you want to switch the output mode from simple to advanced. And as you guys can see, it changes the whole look of everything. So by default, it has us up in the streaming settings. We want to switch over to the recording settings since this video is how to record with OBS Studio. And now you guys can choose your recording path. This is going to be where all of your videos are saved. I definitely recommend finding a custom place where you want to have all your OBS videos saved, different from like the rest of all the other videos on your computer. Because if you just let all the videos get crumbled together, it's going to make a mess and you're not going to be able to find your videos. So I recommend doing it like I do and make an OBS folder on your hard drive and then save all the videos there. You don't want to select generate file name without space. I think that just means there's going to be a bunch of dashes in the name of it. For recording format, this is up to you guys. Obviously, if you want to record in a specific format that you like, you can do that. Most people are going to want to either use MOV or MP4. MP4 is by far the standard. It looks the best out of the two, but MOV will save you some file space and pretty much looks exactly the same as MP4, and that's the one that I use. So again, if you guys want a little bit better quality, but you want a little bit more file space, you can choose MP4. But if you want to save on that file space and you don't mind a little bit of quality difference, then go with MOV. Alright, now you guys want to come down to audio track, and earlier when we selected the desktop and the microphone, that's two audio tracks. You guys want to make sure you have two audio tracks selected here. And now moving down to encoder, right now it says use stream encoder, and that's actually why we have this orange warning down here at the bottom. For the encoder, this is going to depend on your computer. First of all, if you want to use your processor to do all the encoding power for your video recording, then you want to select X264. That's for if you just want to have your processor do everything, if you have a really good processor and not a good graphics card. But in most people's cases, what you're going to want to do is select your GPU. So for me, I have a video graphics card, and that's why I have the NVIDIA NVNC options here. Now, I'm not too sure what the difference between the two NVIDIA NVNC options are, but I've been using NVIDIA NVNC H.264 for a while now, and I noticed this gives me the best quality, and it just works the best, so I definitely recommend this option if you have a NVIDIA graphics card. And if you have an AMD graphics card, I'm sure there's going to be a different option in here to use your AMD graphics. So again, if your graphics card is good enough for that, use your graphics. It's probably going to handle it better than your processor will, unless you have a really beefy processor. Alright, now moving down, we have a rescale output option here, but we're not going to use it because we're not downscaling our video like we talked about earlier in the video tab. For the custom muxer settings, we're not going to put anything. We now have a whole new array of options down here to go through since we selected our encoder up here. The first being rate control. Don't change this, just leave it on CBR. This stands for constant bit rate. This is just what everybody uses. Now for the bit rate, personally, I use 18,500. This gives really crisp 1080p videos. I probably overkill it a little bit. You would probably be fine doing like 15,000, 16,000, but I'm just saying what I do, and I think 18,500 is a great bit rate for recording. Next, for keyframe interval, we're gonna put this on 2 seconds. All right, now for the preset, guys, if you have a really bad CPU, you're going to want to select fastest all the way up at the top. If you have a really good CPU, you're going to want to select one of the slower options down at the bottom. Personally, I've been using slowest for a while now with my Ryzen 7 and I've had no problems, but if you guys have a worse CPU and you notice that that's giving you lag, I definitely recommend changing this down to like good quality or medium quality. I even remember back in the day when I had a much worse computer, I would run it on faster or fastest. So it's all depending on how good of a CPU you have for this option, guys. Next, for the tuning, I would put it on high quality. For the multipass mode, I don't know why you'd want to have a quarter resolution. We're going to want to put it on two passes on full resolution. For the profile, you can either use main or high, it really doesn't matter, but I usually just use main. I don't recommend using the look ahead or the psycho visual tuning settings. I don't use either of them in my recording. Leave GPU at what it is and max B frames at 2. And we are finally done with the recording settings inside of OBS Studio. You guys want to make sure you hit apply in the bottom right, and now we can hit OK. So, wow. Told you guys there was a lot of settings inside of OBS Studio, and we're not even done yet. Now I'm going to show you guys how to set up a few scenes inside of OBS Studio so you can record. Alright, so you guys can see that we have a blank screen here. Basically, over here on the left are scenes. This is the collection of all of our video sources and everything in a particular segment. So, to give an example, I'm going to create another scene here, scene 2. And now, on this first scene, if we come down to the plus down here on the bottom and add in display capture and then click OK, you guys can see that now it's capturing my desktop. And now if I click over here on scene 2, it goes back to that blank screen. Basically, these scenes are just different collections of the sources you have. So if you want to have one scene where it's like full screen of your webcam, and then the other scene is your gameplay with your webcam in the corner, you can do that really easily here. So yeah, let's actually set that up. We already have our desktop in here. Now I'm going to add in my face cam. To add a webcam, you guys want to come down here to the plus sign at the bottom. Then you guys are going to want to find video capture device. It's down here. Okay. Now you guys are going to want to find your webcam under the device list. And you can actually come down here and change the FPS type and resolution to custom. So I want to make sure that my webcam is coming out 1080p on 60 FPS. And you can also change the video format and the color space to 709 and the color range to full. I'm just giving you guys the full rundown on what I do. Alright, so just for the video's sake, I just dragged in a picture of me from like one of my old thumbnails just to show like what the webcam would look like up there in the top left. So now if you guys wanted to move around the webcam, you could just click on it, move it to the top right. You know, you can resize it, make it bigger or smaller. And there's also a lot of filter effects that you can do on video devices. If you right click on video capture device and go into filters, and then right click on effect filters and add. So now that we have our webcam in here and our desktop, this is what most people are gonna need. I'm gonna switch my display capture to my other monitor. You can do that by clicking on it, and then it says right here, display. We're gonna move that to the other monitor. That just looks a lot better. It's not doing that like endless mirror effect. So now I'm gonna show you guys how you would make the full screen video effect. You just go over to scene 2, add in your video capture device again, and I don't recommend using the add existing tab right here because anything that you change on this page is also gonna change it on the other one. So if you want to have like two separate instances of your webcam, just make a new one. You're going to select your camera again and select all the FPS and all that. And now you can just reposition the webcam to be the entire screen. So it's as simple as doing your intro with the webcam full screen and then clicking on the other scene and getting into your video. Anyways, guys, I really hope this video helps you out. This video is definitely going to be a little bit long, but I wanted to make it as detailed and as good as I could. I haven't made an OBS Studio tutorial video in like 3 years, and I definitely know there's some of you out there that want to make some YouTube videos, and this is going to help you out a bunch. So if this video did help you guys out, make sure you guys drop a like on the video, subscribe to FUZIONHERE, and also drop a comment down below letting me know that the video helped you, and also any comments or concerns that you encounter during this video. I'm always responding to comments and helping you guys with your issues. Anyways, go stream Money Up, new song out now, link in description and comments. It's been Josh for FUZIONHERE. I'll see you guys in the next one.